I'm Dr. Abdul Rahman Abdul Jalil Al Abadiya. I am the Imam and the Khatib in this mosque. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. I want to tell you about the story of Prophet Shu'aib alayhi salam, from the Holy Quran. The first thing, the Prophet Shu'aib is the one of four Arab prophets. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was taking the hand of Abu Dharr and said, "Ya Abu Dharr, there is four Arab prophets." And he told him that Nabi Hud alayhi salam, Prophet Hud alayhi salam, Prophet Salih alayhi salam, Prophet Shu'aib alayhi salam, and your Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They are four Arab prophets and sent to Arab people. Sayyidina Shu'aib alayhi salam, he is a speaker of all prophets, you know, the Khatib al-Anbiya, because he has a good language and the meaning come in the heart. When I was the time, Prophet Shu'aib tells people, "You must pray Allah and don't pray the stone." They said, "Tabiq al-Mahdi." They said, "Prophet Shu'aib, you talk to us too much, you must give us a miracle or the evidence that you are tell us the truth." Prophet Shu'aib said, "If these stones tell you that no God but Allah and I am a prophet, you are believe." They said, "We are believing." Prophet Shu'aib asked the stone and tell him, "Who's Allah and who's I am?" The stone said, "There is no God but Allah and you are a prophet. You came with the truth." Then, like the earthquake happened, all the stone fell down and damaged. A lot of people believe in Nabi Shu'aib alayhi salam, but the king and his group punish the believers. So, a little believer stayed with Nabi Shu'aib alayhi salam. Then, a very heat comes from the sun, but they don't believe. Allah tell Prophet Shu'aib, "You must go far from this area." And then the big cloud, black cloud, come to people's Madinah. They thought it will be rain. So all the people are around under the cloud. And a very huge sound come from this cloud, and all the people did. Prophet Shu'aib came to his people and took with him.
It's like banishment.
Yeah.
From Allah.
Yeah. Prophet Shu'aib and talk to dead people, tell them that,
"وَيَا قَوْمِ لَقَدْ أَبْلَغْتُكُمْ رِسَالَاتِ رَبِّي وَنَصَحْتُ لَكُمْ فَكَيْفَ آسَى عَلَى قَوْمٍ ظَالِمِينَ."
You know that the Prophet Shu'aib alayhi salam said to people of Madinah, Allah said in the Holy Quran, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim,
وَإِلَى مَدْيَنَ أَخَاهُمْ شُعَيْبًا قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُهُ وَلَا تَنْقُصُوا الْمِكْيَالَ وَالْمِيزَانَ إِنِّي أَرَاكُمْ بِخَيْرٍ وَإِنِّي أَخَافُ عَلَيْكُمْ عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ مُحِيطٍ."
There is six bad habits for people of Madinah. They are praying stone, they are cheating when they are buying and selling, and they are cutting the rope and punish the people and take their money. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And كان أول ما احتكر. You know that the meaning of الاحتكار. In الاحتكار, I put my goods in the market. When the price go up, I buy it. Okay. كانوا محتكرين. Nabi Shu'aib tell him that is the wrong thing you do. But they said to Prophet Shu'aib alayhi salam, in the Quran, Allah says,
قالوا يا شعيب وصلاتك تأمرك أن نترك ما يعبد آباؤنا أو أن نفعل في
have a big family, he take all of his rooms. But if someone don't have a big family, they punish him and